Today I will be talking about X86 PIE, make kernel images virtual address flexible. I hope this topic will not be boring for you. So let's start our presentation. Next. Here is the outline for today's presentation. Firstly, I will introduce some basic knowledge about compiling and the kernel address space layout. Secondly, I will show how to build the kernel as a position independent executable and talk about some challenges we have encountered. Next, I will explain how to relocate and move the kernel downwards. Then I will discuss the impact of PIE on the size and the performance. Finally, I will show the current status of our PIE patch set and its usage. And we will also talk about our future plans about it. This is the first part. The building process involves the compiling and the linking. Firstly, each source file is compiled into an object file, and then the linker could compile one object file into a single ELF file. This is a simplified description, as the detail could be more complicated. So what is PIE? Position independent executable is an ELF file format and a linking technique. It aims to enhance program security and randomness. For no PIE program, when it is loaded into the memory, its memory layout is look like this. Its start address is usually fixed. However, for a PIE program, its start address can be randomized. So for each loading, it can have different load base. And when the kernel address space layout randomization ASLR is enabled, the memory layout is also randomized. That is the stack area and the heap area and the map area can be also randomized. Next, about addressing model. The addressing model refers to how to calculate the effective address within an instruction. Different architectures they have different address models. Today, we will only talk about two common types. The first one is absolute addressing. That is, the effective address is specified in the operand of the instruction directly. Then when the program is loaded into a different address, the target address is also changed, and we have to modify the instruction. For the second one is PC relative addressing. The effective address is calculated by adding the offset in the operand to the next instruction address. The offset may be positive and negative, but when the program is loaded into a different address, then the target address and the next instruction address is moved together, so the offset is keep the same. Then it is suitable for PIE. No relocation is needed. When talking about the PIE, GOT may be used and combined with address randomization. What is GOT? GOT global offset. The global offset holds the symbol address which could be changed during the runtime. It allows the EF file to be run at a different address, no matter what the code or data is loaded. Although GOT provides flexibility, but it results in slower and larger code. Firstly, it introduces indirection that if we try to get the value of an variable, we have to get the address first from the GOT and then use the address to access the variable. This needs one more memory access and one more instruction. Secondly, the address in the GOT may be changed during the runtime, so we need to perform the relocation for it. So kernel doesn't like it. The GOT in kernel in the final kernel F is almost empty. Then next about kernel address space layout. This is the four-level paging kernel address space layout. As we can see, the kernel image is located in the top 2 GB of the address space, and the module area and fixed map area are also located in this range. Then why the kernel image is placed in the top 2 GB? The main reason is for the size and the performance. Firstly, x86 64 instruction set supports sender extension, which means that we can use the move instruction to load a 32-bit median value into a 64-bit register. And the 32-bit value would be then extended into the 64-bit value. So the kernel has used this feature. Its start address is at 0xFFFFF at 0000. Its 31st bit is set to 1. Then the lower 32-bit value could be then extended to match the original value. For example, when we try to move the symbol value of text into the RDX register, if we try to use the move instruction with a 32-bit immediate operand, then it only takes up 7 bytes. However, if we try to use the move instruction with 64-bit immediate operand, it would need 10 bytes. So the former one is smaller. Then for the 64-bit instruction set, it supports PC relative addressing, which is usually smaller than the absolute addressing, and it didn't need any relocation during the linking, so the building process would be faster. Then, all these features can be enabled by the compiler option. By setting the memory model as kernel, then it makes the branch instruction as a PC relative, and it would use the same extended model for move instruction and load effective instruction. So for x86 64 kernel image's virtual address is fixed. It is not safe and not flexible. Then an attacker could do code use attacks easily. So in order to increase the difficulty of code use attacks, kernel address space layout randomization was introduced. It moves the kernel image as a unit in the top 2 GB. And it allows for physical and virtual address randomization. However, there are a few shortcomings to it. First is low entropy, only 2 GB. The relocated range is only 2 GB. So there are only a few locations the kernel can fit in. Then this also means an attacker could guess the address without too much trouble. For the second one is one single address could expose the base address because the kernel image is moved as a unit. So how to address this shortcomings. For the first one, we could build the kernel image as a PIE to allow it to be put at any virtual address. For the second one, the community has provided FG KASLR, which enables function level randomization. Also, we have found out that other architectures such as ARM64 and S390 has used the PIE for KASLR. They build the kernel as a PIE for a relocatable kernel. So we think we could build the kernel as PIE to enhance the KASLR. The second part, then how to build the kernel image as a position independent executable. The first is the compiling process. We want to use PC relative addressing for PIE kernel. Why? Because we want to try to move the kernel image below the top 2 GB. So when the kernel is moved down, the send extended absolute addressing wouldn't work correctly. So we have to instruct the compiler to generate a PC relative addressing. Then it is easy for C source file. We just use the compiler option, FPIE. Then the compiler could generate a PC relative addressing directly. However, for example file, we have to change the existing absolute addressing. This would be difficult to maintain if someone forget it. So we have extended the object to validate PIE building, which we have do some checks in the object to for each file. The second problem is the memory model. The normal kernel uses the kernel memory model, but it is not compatible with FPIE option. So we have to change the memory model as small, which is still in 2 GB range. However, this would lead to some problems. For example, the stack protector, the kernel usually uses GS segment register for stack canary access. This is implied by the kernel memory model. When we change to use small memory model, the compiler would treat the kernel image as a user space program. So the compiler would generate FS segment register for stack canary access. Then luckily we have a new compiler option which can allow us to choose the segment register and x86 32-bit kernel has used this new compiler option for its stack canary access. We can use it too for 64-bit kernel. When PIE compiling is enabled, the compiler would generate GOT reference for undefined symbols. As we talked before, the kernel don't want any GOT reference, so we have to use hidden visibility to tell the compiler that the address or symbol is in the final elf, then it can safely use the PC relative addressing like before. However, there are some exceptions. Firstly, the compiler would always generate GOT reference for weak symbols, and for and some compiler features would also generate a JIT reference in discuss the hidden visibility. So for PIE kernel, the JIT the JIT is not empty. Then we will talk about some challenges we have encountered during the development. First is the F-tree snowball patching. When the trace pointer is enabled, the kernel would patch the call instruction as a NOP instruction for performance. But when PIE is enabled, the compiler would generate a six-byte JIT in direct call instead of the original 5-byte direct call, then the patch wouldn't work correctly. Actually, we can patch the six bytes JIT in direct call as a 6 bytes direct six bytes NOP instruction. But as we talked before, we didn't want any JIT reference, so we choose to patch the first byte as a five byte NOP instruction, followed by 1 byte NOP instruction. Then the first 5 byte NOP can be patched as before. That means when the trace pointer is enabled, the first 5 byte NOP is patched as a direct call directly, because the target function is still in the PC relative adjusting range. Actually, we thought this is a compiler bug because we have used the hidden visibility, but it doesn't take effect. We have posted a bug for GCC, and the fix has been merged. Then the head code. Here we talk about the C source code. The head code runs in a low identity mapping address during the early booting. So the runtime address is different with compile time address. And there is no high address mapping during at that time. So absolute address couldn't work correctly, but the compiler may generate absolute addressing for accessing globals. This would lead to booting failure. So the kernel has used a hack called the fix up point function. You use this function to access the globals. The function works like this. First, get the offset to the text section, and then plus the base physical address. So the final address is the physical address for the symbol. But whether to use this hack depends on the code generation or compile, and the claim differs from GCC, and it also is confused to the development, because they don't know when to use this hack, when should they use this hack to access the globals. Then for PIE building, all generated references are PC relative addressing, so we don't need any fix up point hack here. But we still need absolute addressing for some symbols during the early page table building. So we have to use the 64-bit move instruction in line assembly. Also, this let us think if we could build the head code as PIE for normal kernel, not only the PIE kernel, because if we build the head code as PIE, then no fix up point as needed. You can get a read of this hic. After talking about the compiling process, let's discuss the linking process. Before that, let's first introduce what a relocation is. It is a linking optimization. The linker would convert memory operand as a mediator operand to reduce one memory access. This is useful for the linking, for the linker. Then for PIE kernel, then for user space program, PIE compiling and PIE linking are used together. Should we use PIE linking for PIE kernel too? However, the kernel is different from user space because if we try to use no PIE linking, then it is simple and compatible with the current kernel relocation. But it has a problem because it would use wrong relocation relaxation because we keep the compile time address in the top 2 GB, then the starter address, then the compile time address could still be sign extended. According to the spec, when PIE linking is not enabled and the address is located in the lower 32-bit address space, then the linker would choose the first one. So it would be so for the first one, the symbol value, the symbol address would be sign extended. But if we move the kernel down, if we move the kernel below the top 2 GB, then the sign extended address would be wrong. Then if we try to use PIE linking, then because PIE linking is standard for torches these days, and we can make the kernel same as user space program. And also, ARM64 kernel has used PIE linking for a long time. And we can use the torches for PIE too, same as the user space program. But it would generate a dynamic relocation table, but the focus doesn't like it because they think the memory size is increased. Now we choose the first. In our PIE patch set, we use the no PIE linking at present. The third part: how to relocate and move the kernel downwards. Before discussing the kernel relocation, I will introduce the relocation table, which is used during the kernel relocation. The relocation table records information about where and how the relocation should be applied. Each relocation table section is associated with a section where the relocation is applied. Then each relocation item has three members. The first member points to the place where the relocation should be applied, and the second member points to the symbol, the symbol in the symbol table, and it also includes the relocation type, which tells the linker how to calculate the final operand in the instruction. What is the relocation type? The purpose of the relocation type is for address calculation. The table in the right contains all the relocation type for x86-64. Now let's understand how the address is calculated by the linker. For example, let's consider the first instruction in the final kernel elf that is load effective address instruction. The relocation type is x86 64 PC 32. So the formula is S plus A minus P. S is the symbol address, that is the end initial text. And A is the offset, that is the frame size plus 4. Why is 4? I will explain later. And P is the place where the relocation is applied, that is the instruction address is at FFF8 1000, and well, the operand is at 803. So the P is the place where the operand is. Then as we talked about before, the four PC relative addressing, the operand is the offset to the next instruction address. So the final offset is calculated by the formula is S plus A minus P. Then we can get the final offset is 0x01203 5F51. Then how to get the effective address? As we talked before, the effective address is calculated by adding the offset to the next instruction. So the offset is S plus A minus B P, and the next instruction is P plus 4, that is 0007. So the final value is S minus frame size, which is the same as the instruction I listed there. So the relocation table has all the information the linker needs to calculate the final address. Then for kernel relocation, it uses this table same as the linker. Firstly, this table, relocation table, is usually jumped in the final elf. So we have to use this compiler option to generate the relocation table for the final kernel elf. Then, for the second step, we have to use a tool to convert each relocation item into a 32-bit value to reduce the size of the relocation table. Why? Because we only need to keep the R offset member. And although it is 64-bit value, but it can send extended, so we only need a 32-bit value. For x86 64 kernel, in the final elf, there are only three relocation types. The first one is the 64-bit relocation for data section relocation, and the second one is 32-bit inverse relocation for per CPU variable, and the last one is 32-bit relocation for normal variable, which can be sign extended. After generating the new relocation table during the decompilation, the kernel can apply relocation according to this new relocation table. So as we talked before, actually, only absolute addressing needs relocation. For PC relative addressing, the offset is keep same if the program is loaded into different addresses. So actually, we shouldn't perform relocation for PC relative addressing. However, for perceived variable for SMP, it is special because the perceived section is mapped at address zero, and the kernel and we use GS segment register to access the perceived variable. So the kernel sorter it is segment based. No relocation is needed because the symbol address is the offset to perceived address. Is already the offset to perceived address, perceived area. Then, if we try to move the perceived area, we just need to modify the value in the GS segment register. Then, for the PC relative addressing, the kernel try to subtract the relocation offset from the immediate part. That is look like this. First, during the runtime after the relocation, the new IP is the IP plus the relocation offset. So we can subtract the relocation offset from the immediate part. Then we can still get the right address. However, for PIE building, there is a problem because we try to move the kernel below the top 2 gigabytes, then the relocation offset could be larger than 2 gigabytes, but the immediate part is only 32 bit. So we choose to subtract the relocation offset from the GS base, that is GS register. Then once the kernel subtract relocation offset from the GS register, then there is no relocation needed for PC relative addressing anymore. The formula is look like this. GS minus the relocation offset. Then we also think if we could use this method for normal kernel too, because there actually in the final elf we could find out that the PC relative addressing instruction are more than the absolute addressing instruction. So if we use this method and no relocation is needed for PC relative addressing, then the relocation table is decreased. For PIE kernel, there is also a problem with the code patching. What is the code patching? That is, the kernel would modify the code during the runtime. For example, alternative patching. It looks like this. That is, there we list the old instruction and the new instruction and the flag. During the booting, the kernel would detect the specified CPU future. If the flag is detected, then it would try to the new instruction instead of the old instruction for performance. However, there is a problem for PIE because for normal kernel, when we try to access globals, the compiler would generate absolute addressing, and during the relocation, the kernel can perform relocation for the absolute addressing. Then the final address for the globals is character. However, for PIE kernel, whether reference is PC relative addressing, then if we move the new instruction from the replacement section into the text section, then the offset is wrong. So we have to modify the offset. For the offset, that is, we have to plus the offset between the replacement section and the text section. Then we can make the PC relative addressing still work. Then for PIE kernel, the kernel relocation process is same. The only difference is the step two. We only keep the 64-bit relocation because the data section relocation is always generated. And also, we talked about before that the GOT in the PIE kernel is not empty, so we have to generate a GOT entries relocation because we use the no PIE linking, the link wouldn't generate the relocation for GOT. We have to do this by ourselves. And then in the final relocation process, after the kernel is built as PIE, we can put it at any virtual address, so we can extend relocation range for KSLR. That is the final relocation offset is PIE relocation offset plus KSLR relocation offset. What is the PIE relocation offset? That is we first choose a 2 gigabyte hole for the kernel, then we perform the KSLR relocation in this 2 gigabyte address space. Then we have extended the KSLR relocation range. After building the kernel as PIE, then we can move the kernel downwards easily. First, we combine the kernel image and the module area and module area, fixed map area as a unit, allow it to be put at any virtual address. Why? Because we should keep the module area and the kernel image in 2 gigabyte range. Then we can still use PC relative addressing for kernel module. Then why we put the fixed map area in this kernel image area too? Because the module area and the fixed map area use same PGD tables. So we don't want to make it complicated. So we just put the fixed map area in this range too. Then this also means the fixed map area for PIE kernel can also be randomized. After move the kernel below the top 2 gigabyte, there are some changes we should make. First is the physical address and virtual address translation for kernel image address. Because we have moved the kernel image below the top 2 gigabyte, the calculation should be changed. And also, there are some subsystems that assume that assumption about the kernel address. First, for example, the top PGD entry may doesn't exist. We have made a problem in the V6 core page building for four-level paging because it assumes the kernel is still in top 2 gigabyte and the vSyscall page is still in the top 2 gigabyte. Then it would then after we move the kernel downwards, it triggers a warning. Then the second problem is the BPF call GIT code generation. If it would generate a call instruction by this function, and and for PIE kernel it would also trigger a warning in this function. Then we talk about the size and the performance on PIE, on PIE kernel. We have tested three cases. That is, we are no PIE, normal kernel without a PIE patch set, we without our PIE patch set, the second one is PIE configure is disabled and the PIE configure is enabled. As we can see, the result and we have tested two different configuration. That is the one is the default configuration and the second one is Ubuntu configuration. As we can see, for PIE kernel, the file size is increased because we need more instructions for PIE kernel. That as we can see, the text section increased. So why is the text section is increased? There are two cases we can introduce. The first is if we try to access an array element for PIE kernel, it first should get the base address of array and then use the second move instruction to get the array element. However, for no PIE kernel, it only needs one instruction directly because the base address of array can be then extended. The second one is switch case optimization. For PIE kernel, the compiler would generate compare and jump instructions. And however, for no PIE kernel, it would generate a jump table. Then only one instruction is needed. So the text section is increased due to the two cases. We also tested the PIE on two benchmark. The first one is Hikma bench, and the second one is kernel bench. And the result shows there is no notable changes for PIE kernel. And the final part, status. The current status of PIE patch set. Actually, the original patch set is posted by Thomas 4 years ago. But it only extended the relocation range from 2 gigabyte to 3 gigabyte for KSR, and it would lead to some boot failures on some configurations. Then this year we have posted our new RFC patch set, which is based on his patch set. But we made some design changes. For example, the new per CPU variable relocation, and our patch set allows it to be put any address space, put any address. We have extended the relocation range to 512 gigabyte as an example in our patch set, and we also fixed the boot failures on Thomas patch set, and we have tested the PIE on all ES configurations. Except for enhancing the KSR, what we could use the PIE kernel, or what the PIE kernel could be used? First, we have used the PIE kernel for our guest PV kernel, which is designed for a software-based hypervisor. We call it PVM. Yet the paper about the PVM has been accepted this year. We use PIE kernel to make the guest and host kernel address space not overlapped to reduce the TLB flush. So our future plans, we want to improve our building process. First, we need more compiler support. For example, the previous problem we talk about, we want the compiler can solve these problems. And the second one, we want to use PIE linking. We want to use PIE linking if it is accepted by the folks. Then the final goal is to upstream. We want to upstream our PIE patch set. However, the focus concerns the use cases. However, we didn't find more use cases. An idea is that if we could use PIE kernel for new user model Linux design, for example, we could use PVOps plus and PIE for a new user model Linux. Then we could use the same binary for user space to boot the user model Linux. However, it's just an idea. We didn't start it. So that's what. Thank you. Sorry, my presentation is time out. Have any question?
We have another session.
Sorry. If you have any question, can come here. We can talk about it later. Sorry.